محمد رسول الله عليه الصلاة والسلام.
الحمد لله. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما آتاكم الرسول فخذوه وما نهاكم عنه فانتهوا، صدق الله العظيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. درشة الله. Respected elders, mothers and sisters listening at home, Hazrat Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala an is the narrator. He is the cousin of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, نظر النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إلى عمر ذات يوم فتبسم. Ibn Abbas is the narrator. He says that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one day he saw Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an fatabassama and smiled at him. He saw Umar radiallahu ta'ala an and he smiled at him. وَقَالَ يَبْنَ الْخَطَّابِ أَتَدْرِي لِمَ تَبَسَّمْتُ فِي وَجْهِكَ. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam questioned Hazrat Umar ibn al-Khattab, and he said, O son of Khattab, do you know why I have smiled at you, or why I smile at you? This was the habit of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When you see his face, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was very beautiful. It is as if though there was a natural smile on his face. And this is what we need to adopt also, because this is the sunnah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. MashaAllah, we need to make an effort that when you see our Muslim brothers, greet them, make salam to them, and give them a smile. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يتبسم. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يضحك. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would generally smile. And when you smile, that is an indication that you have some connection, some love for that individual. So there is no reason, you don't have to give a reason. But here, specifically, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is addressing Umar ibn al-Khattab, that you saw me smiling at you, but do you know why I smile at you? Subhanallah, Sahaba ikiram ajma'in were well-mannered people. Sometimes we picture them to be those who are wearing just a simple lungi, a loincloth with patches, and as if though they had no manners. These were people who ruled the world. He's in Umar ibn al-Khattab. And he looked at Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam. This was a common answer which the companions would give. Allahu wa rasuluhu a'lam. Allah and his Rasul know best. Allah and his Rasul know best. Now the glad tidings given. Yes. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ نَزَرَ إِلَيْكَ بِالشَّفْكَةِ وَالرَّحْمَةِ لَيْلَةُ عَرَفَ وَجَعَلَكَ مِفْتَاحُ الْإِسْلَامِ. O Umar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the glad tidings that on the day of Arafat, in this hadith it talks about the night of Arafat. It's a very special day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala looks at all the hujjaj, the manner of worship, how they stand, how they supplicate, their recitation of the kalam. And in the hadith it comes that during the day of Arafat, shaitan is in its weakest capacity, weakest level, very, very weak. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that I saw shaitan to be skin and bones on the day of Arafat. Totally skin and bones. Very, very unhealthy. Very, very unhealthy on the day of Arafat. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah looked at you, O Umar, on the night of Arafat, and He looked at you with mercy and compassion. What a great sahab. نَظَرَ إِلَيْكَ بِالشَّفْكَةِ وَالرَّحْمَةِ Allah نے تمہیں دیکھا شفقت اور رحمت کے ساتھ. He looked at you with compassion and mercy. Not only that, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam furthermore says, Allah has chosen you to be the key for Islam. مفتاح means key. مفتاح الإسلام means the key for Islam. Now what is meant by the key for Islam? When the door is locked, if you need to unlock that door, to open that door, what happens? You need the key. Muhaddithin have mentioned what is meant here is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had chosen Umar ibn al-Khattab from Khulafa'i Rashidin generally, that Allah will take him to be the means of spreading Islam to all corners of the world. That is why during the Khilafat of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab, for 10 years, Allahu Akbar, what the Romans took pride in and the Persian Empire, everything was taken away. This was the tawajjuh of Umar ibn al-Khattab, and Allah used him, and everything came into the control of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab. Whilst he was just stationed in Madinatul Munawwara, he would just make ishara, come on, you go there, this is what you need to do, this is what you need to do. The entire region came into the control of the Muslimin. Subhanallah. This was the status and maqam of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab. Really an incredible, incredible individual. Now, I have deliberately chosen this kitab, which is Nuzhatul Majalis. I was reading through this, and I came across some of the virtues of Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala. And what is fascinating here in this kitab are the narrators. Majority of the narrators are from the Ahl Bayt. What is the Ahl Bayt? The family members of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Usually there is this fairy tale, a false propaganda that circulates, especially with the Shia doctrine, that they say that the Khulafa'i Rashideen, including Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala an, they were not in good terms with the family of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And a lot of them say even that the Khilafat was snatched away by Hazrat Abu Bakr. Khilafat was snatched away by Hazrat Umar. Khilafat was taken by Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. Allahu Akbar, my respected brothers. What was dunya for Khulafa'i Rashidin? Nothing. What is Khilafat? It was nothing. It was the service, the khidmah that they gave for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is false propaganda. Here we see a close associate of the family of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ibn Abbas quoting. And Ibn Abbas is narrating that I saw Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam looking at Umar ibn al-Khattab, and these are the words what Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him. Subhanallah. Furthermore, let us take one other hadith which is narrated by Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an himself. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an is the narrator. He says, I heard Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, now listen to this hadith, اتقوا غضب عمر فإن الله تعالى يغضب إذا غضب عمر. Narrator is who? Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. And he is saying that I heard from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that abstain from making Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an angry. Because when Umar is angry, Allah is angry. When Umar is angry, Allah is angry. Allahu Akbar. These were the great giants of their time. Sahaba-i kiram ajma'in, bhai khulafa-i rashideen, kaun thi? Abu Bakr Siddiq or Umar Farooq? Now this is not something that is difficult to understand. A man came and he said that, I want to know if Allah is pleased with me or Allah is naraz, displeased with me, how would I know? And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, it's very simple. Ask your parents. If your parents are happy with you, Allah is happy with you.
MashaAllah.
Simple. You want to know if Allah is happy with you? Ask your parents. If your mother and father are happy with you, Allah is happy with you. Obviously, provided that you perform your salah and fulfill the five pillars, the obligations, as a Muslim, what you need to do, a'mal-e saliha. You can't just serve your parents and miss out from your faraiz, that's wrong. But do your farz and respect your parents. If your parents are happy with you, Allah is happy with you. And if your parents are naraz, displeased with you, then no matter what you do, Allah is also naraz with you.
Yes.
SubhanAllah. So Allah's Nabi is saying that beware, don't make Umar angry. Because when he is angry, Allah is also angry. وقال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من أحب عمر فقد أحبني. That person who loves عمر loves محمد المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. ومن أبغض عمر فقد أبغضني. And that person who dislikes or has hatred, عياذ بالله, for حضرت عمر رضي الله تعالى عنه, then he dislikes and has hatred for رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم also. These are important narrations, riwayat, which are narrated by the Ahlul Bayt. Just one hadith, which is narrated by Hazrat Anas radiallahu ta'ala an, and what a beautiful hadith. He says, قَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ رَسُول صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ said, مَنْ أَحَبَّ عُمَرَ عَمَّرَ كَلْبُهُ بِالْإِيمَانِ. The one who has love for Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, Allah will fill his heart with iman. Allah will fill his heart with iman. Ammara ka mana, uske dil ko Allah ne iman se bhar diya. Allah will fill his heart with iman. Allahu Akbar. Another hadith again by Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala an. Now the cousin of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Speaking about the virtues of Hazrat Umar radiyallahu ta'ala an. So what you hear, what the people say, whatever they have to say, it is all wrong. Sahaba ikram ajma'een had love for each other. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and Ahlul Bayt, these were close people, and I have said this many times. The daughter of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and got married to Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Isse bada rishta kya chahiye bhai? Hazrat Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala and says, Ani Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned, يُنَادِي مُنَادٍ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَيْنَ الْفَارُوكِ. See, when you have a graduation ceremony and a person qualifies, then there is a ceremony, people are there, and then a certificate is given to him and a few words to praise that student who is a professional person now. A graduation ceremony, so that everybody must know who this person is. MashaAllah, this person has become a doctor now. He's become a doctor now. So on the day of Qiyamah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there will be some individuals that the angels will make an announcement on the day of Qiyamah. And the angels will take the name. And one of them is Hazrat Umar Farooq. Yunadi munadin yawm al-Qiyamah. On the day of Qiyamah, an announcement will be made. Ayn al-Farooq. Ayn al-Farooq. Umar Farooq, you are in front of me. But that is Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala an. Ayn al-Farooq? Where is Farooq?
Yes.
This is the title of Hazrat Umar radiallahu. Where is Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala an? Hazrat Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala an will walk. And the angels will surround him. Allahu Akbar. This is the honor. This is the honor. You will see that when a person holds that very high position, when he walks, he doesn't walk alone. He's got bodyguards, he's got secretaries, and he's got on the side other people, men, women surround him, all sorts of people walking, writing, and especially in the modern world that we live in, he's there walking alone, and there's about 20 people surrounding him. But on the day of Qiyamah, this is khulus. Angels will surround Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an, and it is said that the gates of Jannah will open up for him. Allahu Akbar Kabira. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq. that we have love for all of the companions and especially the Khulafa'i Rashidin. We end again with one hadith of Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. He is the narrator. Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an had so much love of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an that he would frequently quote one hadith that he personally heard from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hadith is Sami'tu an-Nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul. Hazrat Ali says, I have heard Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, Umar ibn al-Khattab siraj ahli al-Jannah. That Umar ibn al-Khattab is the siraj for the people of Jannah. He is the siraj for the people of Jannah. Siraj is not here at the moment, but he is the siraj of the people of Jannah. What is siraj in the Arabic language? A beam of light. A beam of light. Just say, all of a sudden when you switch on this chandelier, you will see how the light sparks up all of a sudden. Everything becomes brightened. So a beam of light. So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that Umar ibn al-Khattab is the siraj for the people of Jannah. Like he was the beam of light for the people in this dunya. Huh? He was a guidance for many millions. Subhanallah, all of these people who embrace Islam, when the Muslims took control, so many of them embraced Islam. So many. And when they would meet Hazrat Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an, his seerah, his surah, everything was very, very different. When this hadith was informed to Hazrat Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala an, he was given information of this hadith. Hazrat Umar was very particular, although it was in regards to his own praise. So he came running to Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala and said to him, "Why Ali, you are narrating this hadith that Allah's Nabi has mentioned that Umar is the siraj for the Ahlul Jannah. Now, are you sure you've heard this from Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam?" Now imagine, subhanAllah, if it was us, what would we say? Carry on. In my place, carry on. I don't do too much, you know. I just wake up in the night, perform two rakat tahajjud and go to sleep. I don't do too much. But you are actually telling everybody what you do. So how mukhlis was Hazrat Umar ibn al-Khattab? When he heard that Hazrat Ali is quoting this hadith, he went to meet Hazrat Ali. "Bhai, you are saying this hadith to everyone. Are you sure you have heard this from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?" Hazrat Ali said, "Naam, of course I have." Again, he was not satisfied. He said, "Okay, if you say you have heard this from Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ya Ali ibn Abi Talib, I want you to write this entire hadith for me on a piece of paper." This is Hazrat Umar ibn al-Khattab. Huh? "I want you to write this hadith for me on a piece of paper." Hazrat Ali was certain and sure. He said, "No problem. Give me the piece of paper and I will write it for you." Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala an wrote the entire hadith. And said, "Here Umar, now do you believe me that these are the words of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam?" Now everything what I've quoted here is from Nuzhatul Majalis, from this kitab that is in front of you. And according to some narration, it is mentioned that Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an even made wasiyat that when I pass away, I want you to put this piece of paper written by Ali radiallahu ta'ala an in my coffin. Because he is the one who has given shahada that Umar ibn al-Khattab is from the siraj of Ahlul Jannah. There's a possibility that this was before the period of him, the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam giving him the basharat, the ashra mubashara, or whenever this event had taken place. Wallahu alam. But nevertheless, my respected brothers, here we have Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala an, two ahadith narrated by him, and three hadith have been narrated by Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, all of them who are very, very closely related to Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are from the Ahle Bayt, and all of them praise Hazrat Umar, and also Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq, and also Hazrat Uthman radiallahu ta'ala. So this politics was not with Sahaba-i Kiram ajma'in. This politics is with the individuals, with different communities. Sahaba-i Kiram ajma'in were very, very pure people. Ulama have mentioned one of the striking characters of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala an is his humbleness, humility. بہت زیادہ متواضع. Very, very humble person. سيدنا عمر بن الخطاب. It is said that once he was with a group of people traveling, and all of a sudden this very old lady came in front of Hazrat Umar رضي الله تعالى. Now Hazrat Umar رضي الله تعالى عن his means of travel was not something very expensive, not an Arabian horse or a camel. In the hadith it comes that وَهُوَ عَلَى هِمَارٍ, he was sitting on a donkey. He was sitting on a donkey. And that entire group of the companions were with Hazrat Umar رضي الله تعالى عن. And this lady, old lady comes and she stands in front of Hazrat Umar رضي الله تعالى عن. And she says, "Oh Umar, stop, stop, stop. I want to speak to you. When do I get an opportunity to talk to you?" Umar radiallahu ta'ala and stops. Everybody stops with it. Now this old lady decides that I should do islah of Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Do islah. Islah can mean a lady is doing islah of who? Hazrat Umar. Old lady. Yeah, I need to lecture him. Yeah. I need to give you advice. Stop, stop, Umar, stop. I want to advise you.
Yeah.
Umar, stop. What a humble man. He is that man who Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that when Umar walks in one path, the shaitan turns away. So this old lady wants to give a lecture. How does she start? Look at the stern, harsh words. Oh, Umar, look, I know you when you were little. I know you when you were little. See, you are Umar, but I know you when you were Umair. What does she say?
Umair.
Umair. You are Umar, but I know you when you were Umair. This is the beauty of the Arabic language. Subhanallah. You see, when you want to say something that is, or describe something that is small, you use one scale which is known as Isme Tasghir in the Arabic language. So it becomes Fu'ail, like Abdullah, Ubaidullah, and Umar, Umair. So I know you when you were a little Umar. What are you? A little one. You were a little one. But I know you when you were Umair. Listen to me what I have to say to you. So what if you were Umair and now all of a sudden you've become Umar, and now then Umar has become Amirul Mu'mineen. So I know you when you were Umar, I know you when you were Umar, and I know you now that you are Amirul Mu'mineen. What I want to say to you, O Umar, that don't let all of these titles, that you are the Khalifa, Amirul Mu'mineen, don't let takabbur, pride and arrogance take control over you because of all these titles people give you. An old lady is lecturing others, Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Now don't have takabbur in you. Don't take pride inside you. And she continued. فَحَبِسَتْهُ تَوِيلًا تَعِذُهُ. That she wanted to lecture and lecture, give nasiyah to Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala. Hazrat Umar is on his donkey sitting. Until some of the group members were frustrated. That is this how you talk to Amirul Mu'mineen? So they came to Hazrat Umar radiallahu ta'ala and they said to Amirul Mu'mineen, أَتَسْمَعُ كَلَامَ هَذِهِ الْعَجُوزِ. Amirul Mu'mineen, do you want to give time to this old lady and you want to listen to what she is saying? You want to listen to her? Hazrat Umar was a great alim. He knew exactly how and where and when the verses of the Quran was revealed. So Hazrat Umar said to the companions, he said that, look, if this lady was to give me a lecture for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, I would stand and listen to her. She is not an ordinary lady. You may not recognize her, but I recognize this very old lady. She is Khawla bint Sa'laba. She is the wife of Aus bin Samit, the brother of Ubada bin Samit. She is that lady who had put her case forward to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listened to her from the seven heavens and gave a decision in her favor. So be mindful of every individual. And when she speaks and when she stops Amir al-Mu'mineen. She is in that capacity. She is Khawla bint Sa'laba. Do you know who she is? For her, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed verses of the Quran. If you open up the 28th para, under the Quran you have it. If you open up the 28th para, the very first surah is Suratul Mujadala. What is it? Suratul Mujadala. قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is speaking about Khawla bint Sa'laba. Allahu Akbar. So I have to listen to her. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu saying, the incident that occurred with her, again, something very important. She was married to Aus bin Samit, and from Aus bin Samit she had many children also. One night Aus bin Samit wanted to get close to her, to cohabit with her, and she refused. No way, she refused. At that Hazrat Aus bin Samit got very angry. And he said, oh, anti kazahri ummi. Anti kazahri ummi. He said to her that your back, your zahr, zahr in the Arabic language means pushed back. Your back is like the back of my mother. Your back is like the back of my mother. Now he blurted out these words and obviously then regretted. Because in the pre-Islamic era, there were two methods. When a person wanted to separate from the wife, they would either use the term of ilah. Ilah means to take an oath. So someone would say that Wallahi, or he would take a custom and say, I will never ever get close to my wife. I will never approach her. So this would mean a partition between the husband and wife. And the second method is the method of zihar. Zihar. This is the method we are talking about. Zihar would mean that obviously the strongest relationship is with the mother. The mahram, the mother is the strongest mahram for the child. So when the Arabs, if they wanted to separate from any of their wives, they would say, okay, anti ka zahri ummi, your back is like the back of my mother. So you are like my mother. That would mean a separation. So now he uttered the words and he dearly loved Hazrat Khawla bint Sa'laba, now regretting. But no matter what, Hazrat Aus bin Samit said to her that, look Khawla, I am sorry, this out of anger what I have said, but now you are unlawful for me. You are not halal for me. Hazrat Khawla bint Samit was a very strong lady. She came to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she explained her story. She started off by saying, Ya Rasulullah, I'm an old lady now, but in my heydays when I was young, I was very rich. Allah had blessed me with a lot of wealth. I was a wealthy lady. Then I married this man here. Not only did he consume my money, but also my youth and my beauty. Everything has been taken away by this man. My wealth, my beauty, my youth. I'm an old lady now. My family members are scattered everywhere. I have no wealth. Now when I am old, this man, my husband, says, Anti ka zahri ummi. But he is regretting. He loves me and I love him. And we have many children. Is there any way that both of us can be reunited, Ya Rasulullah? It happens many a time. Out of anger, a person says, Wait, talak, 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 talak. And then they come back and they say, look, can you do something? Can you patch up? What's the patch up work? There's no patch up now. The Sharia is not a joke. But here he said, Ka zahri ummi. Now, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, no, you are unlawful for the husband. You have to stay separate. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not reveal to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam any explicit rules with regards to zihar. So as according to their old custom that they would be separated, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, if your husband has said this to you, that means he wants separation and you stay apart. She did not stop at that. She was very forceful in presenting her case. And she said, Ya Rasulullah, I take qasam in the name of that Allah who has revealed the Quran on you, that he has not uttered the words of talaq. How can I be separated from my husband? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again said to her, Khawla, I say to you that I have no specific ruling of Bihar, but what I know is that you have to be separated from your husband. Now her level of taqwa, her love and connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with all respect, she looked at Huzur alayhi salatu wa salam, the respect that one must give to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and she said, Ya Rasulullah, I will make an appeal for my case in the courts of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the court of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will cry and I will make dua. And I am hopeful that Allah will reveal something to you. But in my favor. But in my favor. She said that. Allah. You know, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala an was in the same room. In the women can be very jealous. They wouldn't want you to talk to another woman. So they're always there. And so Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha says that I was in that same room with Khawla bint Sa'laba. Huzur alayhi salam was there. Even I could not hear whilst being in the same room all of the conversation between her and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala heard all of her words. She turned away. And again Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam got in that position, in that posture when normally wahi would come, he would stop doing anything. And sometimes he would shut his eyes. And Sahaba-i Kiram ajma'in would be very, very alert. They would understand. Nobody would speak to him and nobody would say anything to him. He would be in that posture. At times sweat would drip, so much sweat all the time. Allahu Akbar. And so Hazrat Aisha said to Khawla bin Sa'laba, Khawla, bas, don't talk. Allah has already listened to you. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is in this position, in this posture. Wahi is coming, wait. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed. قَدْ سَمِعَ اللَّهُ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ فِي زَوْجِهَا وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. Verily Allah has heard the speech of this woman, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was very forceful to you. قَدْ قَوْلَ الَّتِي تُجَادِلُكَ. She was very forceful with you. وَتَشْتَكِي. تَشْتَكِي means shikayat. وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَى اللَّهِ. And she lodged a complaint in the court of Allah. اور اس نے اللہ کے سامنے شکایت کی. وَتَشْتَكِي إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَامُرَكُمَا. And Allah is the one who was listening to both of your conversations. Hazrat Aisha says, I was in the same room. I could not hear. Allah is saying, I could hear everything what you were talking. وَاللَّهُ يَسْمَعُ تَحَامُرَكُمَا. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ Basir. Allah is all Sami, all hearer, and Allah is Basir, He can see everything. And now the ruling. الَّذِينَ يُظَاهِرُونَ مِنْكُمْ مَا هُنَّ أُمَّهَاتِ مِنْ أُمَّهَاتُمْ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَدْنَهُمْ. If somebody says that, this woman is like my mother, Allah is saying that she does not become your mother. Your mother is only that lady who gave birth to you. مِنْ أُمَّهَاتُمْ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَلَدْنَهُمْ. And some of the people, when they don't like the system of farda, and they want to bypass the system of farda, and they want to sit and enjoy talking with women, they say, oh, baby, you are like my sister. What do you want to do farda from me? What do they say? You are like my sister, Wawa. By you saying she's your sister, she becomes your sister. Some of the old folks say, oh, Betty, you are like my daughter. And if you see all these old folks, you know, they go to back at home and want to get married to 16 and 17 year old women. Yeah. No joke, my respected brother. I've just had one case and the immigration people are troubling him. An old man wants to marry a 17 year old lady. Yeah. La ilaha illallah Muhammad. Mushtaq, I need to phone you, you know. What's happening here? So they say that, oh, you are like my daughter. You see, this is all shaitan. By you saying you are like my daughter, and you see the concept of parda is there. Now Allah is saying, so what if you said that your wife, my wife, her back is like the back of my mother. She is not your mother. She is not your mother. Your mother is only that, the golden rune, the one who has given you birth. Okay, so what is zihar? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, look, these are munkaran, munkaran. These are foolish words that people utter. These are foolish words that people utter. And as a warning. Now again, it is so important, my respected brothers and elders, that even today, a lot of the couples who are married, they don't realize what they are saying. And they feel that nikah will only break by the word talaq. It's not the case. Sometimes if you use very harsh words, very, very harsh words, your nikah can be broken also. Nikah too just. So you have to be very, very careful. Sometimes what happens, a person has not even given talaq to the lady. And then she goes to the court. And then the court decides that, okay, this lady has got nothing to do with the husband. But the husband has not signed any document. The husband has not verbally or in any manner said anything. Mm-hmm. And this lady decides now, because the civil court has given a decision in my favor, mm-hmm. and she goes and she gets married to another person, failing to realize that this is haram, she is doing zina with the second man because she is not free from the first husband. So many masail. So you have the masail which are with the civil court, but then you have the masail which are attached to Islam. So you have to be very, very careful, and that is why fiqh is important. And many a times a person has already given talaq to his wife, which is talaq-e-mughallaza, and yet he says, no, this talaq, I said it in this and I said it in that. And you know, in the heart he is guilty. He is guilty. But yet he wants to shut his eyes and he says that, oh, don't worry, you know, Allah is Ghafoor Rahim. Allah will forgive me. Allah will forgive me. But that guilty conscience, that guilt is there. Mm-hmm. So we have to be very, very careful. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said that anybody who utters such words and disrespects the wife, then he will be penalized for using the wrong words. Just recently there was a man talking to a lady, and he said, Maulana, I am praying this old lady died. And he's talking about his own wife. Can you imagine that? I am praying that this old lady dies. When will she die? I'll bury her. Mera usse chutkara. My God, Allahu Akbar Kabira. Subhanallah, even at your old age, is this how you talk? Is this how you talk about your own wife? As if it is a joke. So we need to understand the masail. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala penalizes that person for doing zihar. And Allah says the penalty for uttering words like anti ka zahri ummi is that you have to free a slave. We haven't got slaves now. Mm-hmm. So if you can't free a slave, then you have to fast for 2 months consecutively. How many months? Mm-hmm. 2 months. The penalty, huh? Mm-hmm. And if for some reason ill health, someone who's very, very ill, if you can't fast, then he has to feed 60 people, miskeen, 60 masakin. As a warning for the brothers who don't take control of their tongue in their marital relationship. Mm-hmm. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfeeq. But talking on the subject of zihar, say for an example today, if someone was to say to his own wife that you are like the back of my mother. You are like the back of my mother. Let's say somebody says that. Then this case must be forwarded to the fuqaha, to the ulama. And this person would either take a qasam, and he would be questioned that when you said that my wife is like the back of my mother, what did you mean? What did you mean? Did you mean that you want to divorce her? And if he says that, yes, this is what I meant, then there is talaq. Even without uttering the words of talaq. In Islam, there is one talaq. But if he says, no, this is not what I meant, then benefit of doubt will be given to us. So these are very complex masail, pechida masail. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq. We touched on this subject with reference to Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala an, wa akhiru da'wana an alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Dua kalli. اللهم صل على سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وسلم تسليما. اللهم تقبل منا وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. سمعنا وأطعنا، غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير، برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.